Hello friends, this lecture is second in the series of two lectures on the topic latitudes and longitudes. So, in the first lecture we had talked about what is globe, what are latitudes, important latitudes, heat zones of the earth, what are longitudes. In the second lecture, that is today, we will be talking about locating places on the earth, international date line, longitude and time, local time, standard time and international standard time. So, let's begin with locating places on the earth. So, as we have talked about two set of imaginary lines in the previous class, that is latitude and longitude. Now, with the help of these two lines, we form a imaginary grid. So, the network of parallels and meridians on the surface of the globe is known as Earth's grid. We can locate any place on the Earth with the help of this grid. If exact location for place is to be known, we should know its position in the north-south direction as well as east-west direction. International date line. Now, the 180 degree meridian is called the international date line. Now, it should be a straight line as the other meridians of the earth, but this line is not kept straight, but it cuts the earth in a zigzag manner on the map. Now, why is it done? It is done so that it does not cut through any island and cause confusion of dates. So what happens is, when you cross an international date line, you have to reset your watch. While crossing it from east to west, one has to add a day or gain a day. While crossing from west to east, a day has to be subtracted. So, coming out to what is longitude and time. As we have seen, latitudes help us demarcate the heat zones of the earth. Likewise, longitudes help us with the time. We already know that Earth rotates on its axis from west to east. The rotation of the Earth gives us the measure of one day, that is 24 hours. Also, the rotation of the Earth makes 360 degree angle. So, we can say that Earth rotates through 360 degrees of longitude in about 24 hours. We can further say that Earth rotates through 15 degrees of longitude in 1 hour and 1 degree of longitude in 4 minutes. So, when the sun is the highest point in the Greenwich, all the places along the prime meridian will have noon midday. As the earth rotates from west to east, the places which are located east of the prime meridian will have a sunrise earlier than those which are located towards the west. It means that Tokyo experiences sunrise much before London. So, we can say that places to the east of prime meridian will be ahead of the Greenwich time than the places to the west of prime meridian. The time at the prime meridian is also called Greenwich Mean Time. What is local time? The time determined with respect to the meridian of a place is called the local time of that place. All the places that fall on the same meridian have the same local time. The local time can be calculated by knowing the meridian of that place and the Greenwich Mean Time. The local time varies from one meridian to another. Now, what about the countries which are very vast? As we know, the local time is different for different meridian. There is bound to be confusion if all the places on different meridian follow their own time. So, in a country like India, there will be total chaos if each meridian followed its own time. It would disrupt the smooth functioning of railways, airways, etc. In order to avoid such confusion, it has become mandatory to adopt local time of some central meridian of the country to provide a standard time for the whole country. Now, GMT is standard time for UK. Likewise, India has an Indian standard time. India is located in the northeastern hemisphere and the standard meridian of the India is 82.5 degrees east longitude, which passes through Allahabad. The difference of time between GMT and 82.5 degree east is 5 hours and 30 minutes. As the standard meridian of the earth is towards the east of the prime meridian, the standard time of India is 5 hours and 30 minutes ahead of GMT. Some countries are so vast in size that it is virtually impossible to adopt a single time for the entire country. Example, Russia has 11 time zones. The Earth is divided into 24 time zones. Each zone covers 15 degrees of longitude. The local time of the meridian passing through the center of each time zone gives the standard time of that particular time zone. As far as possible, the standard time of each zone has been chosen to be exact number of hours ahead or behind GMT. So friends, with this we come down to summarize what we have learned. We have talked about locating places on the earth with the help of imaginary lines which form an earth's grid. So if you know a latitude and a longitude of the place, you can locate that place on the earth precisely. We talked about international date line. It is 180 degree meridian and how you have to adjust your watch if you cross it. We have talked about longitude and time. How do longitude help you find out the time of your place? How do you find it relative to the Greenwich Mean Time? What is local time? How do you find the standard time of a country with the help of a central meridian? What is Indian standard time? And some countries which have more than one time zones. So I give you a task to find out countries or islands which have more than one time zones. With this, I will leave you with a link to the quiz of this chapter. I hope you enjoy it. Happy learning and thank you.